Hello and welcome to session 9, Create Visual Calculations in Power BI. I'm Andrew Conniff, a Microsoft technical trainer specializing in data and AI. Today we'll explore the journey of data analysis using Power BI, and let's dive right in. In this session, we're going to discuss understanding visual calculations and how they differ from measures, creating visual calculations in Power BI Desktop, and using parameters in visual calculations. Visual calculations are a simple way to add calculations to a Power BI report. Think of DAX calculations defined visually on a visual, making the DAX easier to write, understand, and maintain. Visual calculations are defined on a visual such as a table, bar chart, or a matrix, and they provide easy-to-use functions for calculations that are commonly used. When creating a visual calculation, the complexity of the model is not the focus. Simply work with what is on the visual. A visual calculation can refer to any data in the visual, including columns, measures, or other visual calculations. This ability removes the complexity of the semantic model and simplifies the process of adding calculations to our reports. We can use the visual calculations to complete common business calculations, such as running sums or moving averages. DAX in visual calculations works differently from other calculation options. The formula isn't stored in the model, but in the visual itself, and is limited to the data on the visual. So if we need to use something from the model, we must add it to the visual first. This approach simplifies things by avoiding the complexity of the filter context and the model. Visual calculations combine the straightforward context of calculating columns with the flexibility of on-demand calculations from measures. They work on aggregated data instead of detailed data, which often improves performance. If choosing between a new measure or a visual calculation, the visual calculation usually performs better. And since visual calculations are part of the visual, they can refer to the visual structure, offering more flexibility. Creating a visual calculation is straightforward. We select a visual and choose New Calculation. The visual calculation window consists of three major sections as shown on the top to the bottom in the image. The visual preview, which shows the visual which we're working on, and a formula bar where we can add visual calculations. The visual matrix shows the data in the visual and displays the results of visual calculations as we add them. Any styling or theming we apply to the visual isn't applied to the visual matrix. To add a visual calculation, type the expression in the formula bar. For example, the code on the screen calculates the profit by subtracting total product cost from sales amount. The image shows adding the profit calculations to a matrix visual that contains sales amount and total product cost by fiscal year. Now we can see the individual fiscal year and the total for the three different values: sales amount, total product cost, and profit. By default, most visual calculations on a visual are evaluated row by row like a calculated column. Although possible, there's no need to add an aggregation function like sum as you would in a measure. In fact, it's better not to add such aggregates when they're not necessary. This allows for distinguishing between measures and visual calculations expressions. Visual calculations include templates that make it easier to write common calculations. View templates by selecting the template button and observing the values in the dropdown. Each template has a corresponding function which is added to the formula bar when we choose a template. We can also add our own expressions without relying on the templates. We can use many of the existing DAX functions in visual calculations. Since visual calculations work within the confines of the visual matrix, functions that rely on model relations such as use relationship, related, or related table aren't available. Visual calculations also introduce a set of functions specific to the visual calculations. As we add visual calculations, they're shown in the list of fields on the visual and on the visual itself. In visual calculations edit mode, we can hide fields from the visual just like we can hide columns and tables in the modeling view. For example, if we wanted to only show the profit visual calculation, we can hide sales amount and total profit cost from view. Hiding fields doesn't remove them from the visual or from the visual matrix, so the visual calculations still refer to them and continue to work. A hidden field is still shown on the visual matrix, but not shown on the resulting visual. It's recommended practice to only include hidden fields if they're necessary for the visual calculations to work. Many visual calculation functions or templates have an optional axis parameter, and these can only be used in the visual calculations. Axis refers to how the visual calculation traverses the visual matrix. The axis parameter is set to the first axis in the visual by default. For many visuals, the first axis is rows, which means that the visual calculation is evaluated row by row in the visual matrix from top to bottom. These parameter values control how the data is calculated. So rows are calculated vertically across rows from top to bottom. Columns are calculated horizontally across columns from left to right. Rows columns are calculated vertically across rows from top to bottom, continuing column by column from left to right. And columns rows are calculated horizontally across the columns from left to right, continuing row by row from top to bottom. Many functions have an optional reset parameter that is available in visual calculations only. Reset influences if and when the function resets its value to zero or switches to a different scope while traversing the visual matrix. The reset parameter is set to none by default, which means the visual calculation is never restarted. The following list describes the only valid values for the reset parameter. None. That's the default value and doesn't reset the calculation. Highest parent resets the calculation when the value of the highest parent on the axis changes. Lowest parent resets the calculation when the value of the lowest parent on the axis changes. Note that reset expects there to be multiple levels on this axis. If there is only one level on the axis, use partition by. Now let's go to a demonstration and see how this works in Power BI.
All right, so let's talk about visual calculations. We're going to start off with a bar chart, of course, and we're going to put our year from the date table into the y-axis, and then we're going to put the cost from sales in the x-axis. All right, we're starting to see some information show up. So now that we have that there, let's try sorting the results for the bar chart by the year. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to the edge here and sort axis by year. And I actually want sort ascending metrics. I'm going to add the sum of sales. There we go. We got this coming together here. Our next step is to create then a new visual calculation. So we have to have our visual selected. So we're going to say new visual calculation. So what we want to do up here is where we're going to put our calculation. And so we want is the profit. Check and make sure that looks good. And we should get a preview when we select this. There we go. There's our profit. So we've done a calculation inside our visual. The next step is going to, under the new calculation, and we're going to update how this is set up. So we're going to open up this toggle window and we're going to say versus the previous. So it's going to compare it to the previous year. And what we want to do here is it's given us a formula and we want to put in profit where it says field and then commit the calculation. You see we're getting the type ahead. We just tabbed it, have it added, and then commit. All right, versus previous. So here's our profit versus previous. See the numbers are a little bit different. Next we're going to do running sum. And we're going to do the same thing. For running sum, we're going to change this and commit that. Profit versus our previous and then our running sum. And next we want the moving average. So we're going to grab from our template menu here, moving average, and we want profit here. And for window size, we're going to say 2. Commit that. All right, moving average, running sum versus previous, all very good. All right, now our visual has everything in here. So we may not want necessarily to look this way. So let's do a couple formatting things that we can clean this up with. So the first one is going to be, we want to hide the sum of sales and the sum of cost and the profit to see what our visual can actually do without all of the extra information. All right, that looks good. All right, now the next thing we could do is in our visualizations pane, we can move our running sum and moving average to the tooltips well area so we can clean this up a little bit more. So we have a tooltips right here. So that's going to be we want specifically the running sum, moving average, running sum, moving average. That's not going to scroll with us. There we go. Now we're getting a little bit of a cleaner area. There's our versus previous. We have our year, and we'll get our tooltips. We want to confirm that our visual is now looking pretty good, and we're good. We'll go ahead and save that. Go back to the report, and now this is what we have. And there's our tooltips. Previous year, running sum. Excellent. Calculated on the fly without having to create the measures. And it only works in this visual. So let's try this with some other information. Let's create a new page. And we are going to add a matrix visual. Let's go ahead and add one. And to our matrix visual, we're going to add, for the rows, we want our product category. So you can see down here, we have rows and columns and values. And product category is going to be under rows. The year column under columns from our date. And our sales under value. Now, with this selected, we want to add our calculations. We'll just start with new visual calculation. We're going to put in some DAX and we'll commit that, and we will see different values under the calculation. So there's the versus first, and you can see we're getting different results based on what's in our visualization. All right, so if I select my values first over here, I can bring back my DAX. And if I want to update this now, I can. So if I have, I want to add rows, I can add that. I can go in. And add rows. And let's update this. All right, we'll go back to our report. There's our matrix. As extra data, let's make it bigger so we can see it. Much more informative. And now let's create a page 3. We're going to add a line chart visual. And in the well, we're going to add to the x-axis, we're going to put our year and quarter. And then for y is going to be sales. So year and quarter. The y is going to be sales. All right, we have our line. And now let's add a new visual calculation. We're just going to do a running sum. So we make sure this is selected. It is new visual calculation, running sum. And here in the field, we're going to replace that with sum of sales. There it is. We'll commit that. There. That. Very nice. And now, as we did before, we can select our running sum. And we can say, well, let's check for highest parent. Let's commit that and see how that shows our highest parent, and then it returns. So the calculation starts, goes to the highest parent, and then drops back down. And that brings us to the end of this demonstration.
This concludes our session. There are many ways to continue your learning journey. We encourage you to watch other videos in this course or search out your next favorite topic on Microsoft Learn at aka.ms/learn.